Even if your automatic switches are connected to an ASC2 module or are already command equipped, the Wi-Fi app will not read the switch position correctly if the switch is activated by means other than the tablet. For instance, if a train activates a switch through the non-derailing feature, or if the remote control throws the switch, the Wi-Fi app will still show the switch as being in the previous position. The STM2 Switch Throw Monitor can be added so the Wi-Fi device accurately depicts the position of the switch at all times. Install the PDI cable from the LCS connection chain. The sense return terminal at the bottom of the module is connected to the layout's common ground. For a fast track switch, the terminal marked 1 is connected to the RSC lights terminal on the first switch programmed with TMCC on your layout. Press the program button on the module, followed by SW on a cab 2. Then the first ID number that matches the ID number of the first switch connected, and press set. Finally, press AUX 1 for Lionel switches. Remember when we said not to skip ID numbers for switches? The reason is, if you install an STM2, you can monitor the position of 16 different switches, and they are all in sequential order without skipping. So, if you program an STM2 with the number 17, which must correspond with the ID number of the first switch connected to the module, the remaining 15 ID numbers follow consecutively. Most operators would start with the number 1 on the first module. If you have more than 16 switches and you've installed the necessary number of ASC2s to control all of them, or if they're already TMCC equipped, then both the individual switch IDs and the IDs on the STM2 modules will need to match. The first STM2 would monitor switches 1 through 16. The second would monitor switches 17 through 32, and so on.